church, we are here to worship the Lord. He's worthy of our praise. In Psalms 33 says that rejoice in the Lord, for your righteous, for the praise from the upright is beautiful. Praise the Lord with harp. Make a melody to him, an instrument of 10 strings. Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully with a shout of joy. For the word of the Lord is right, and all his work is done in truth. He loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of goodness of the Lord. Let all the earth fear the name of the Lord. Let all the inhabitants in the world stand and awe of him. For he spoke and it was done. He commanded and it stood fast. Blessed is the nation whose God is in the Lord, the people he has chosen as his own inheritance. Let the glory of the Lord be in this place. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's worship the Lord. We prepare our heart, our soul, and our strength to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Clap your hands. God provides. You are the God who heals. God, you're always there for us. You are the Lord of peace. You are the Lord our banners. You are the Lord our shepherd. You are the Lord of rest. God, you alone are righteousness. Anytime.
Yeah, hold on.
who provides and God who heals, isn't it?
Pray for the peace of Jerusalem.
Shalom, Jerusalem.
Peace. Lord Jesus, for you are our Savior. We just speak your name, Lord Jesus. We just speak your name. I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind, 'cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
Worthy, worthy, worthy.
Sisters, now, Almighty God, Almighty God, you are worthy, worthy of our praise. Almighty God, ancient of days, you. Jesus is the greatest man in history. Jesus had no servant, but they called him master. He had no degree, but they called him teacher. He had no medicine, but they called him healer. He had no wins in the battle, physical battle, but king spared him. He had no wins. He had conquered the world. He did not live in the castle, but they call him King of Kings or Lord. He lorded no nation, but they called him kings. He committed no crimes, but they crucified him. He was buried in the tomb, but he lives again. His kingdom was not in this world, but lies in every heart of the believer. He spoke of love and forgiveness, and his word has transformed millions. He offered no material wealth, yet we consider him the treasure of our life. Thank you, Jesus, for everything that you have done. Amen.
Let's give our hands to Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. You may be seated. How many are glad you are here? Amen. Oh my goodness. Jesus is here. Amen. He sent a messenger. Do you know who? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning, Pastor. Wow, Pastor Pat Tyrone is here with us. How wonderful it is to have a man of God to share it so that we can be edified, so that we will grow in the Spirit, we will walk in His footsteps. Amen. Just a few announcements. It will take only 5 minutes and 1 hour to do this. Everybody's awake, Pastor. That's a good sign. So we welcome Pastor Tyrone with us today. And I know I heard that this is my first time to have you, I think. But to some, you have met them already, and they speak good things about you. We have no Bible study today with Pastor John. There's an evening service tonight, and get ready, praise and worship team. Remember also that we have a tin can for missions for the Rescue Sri Lanka tin can. You have to hand them to Pastor Maggie or any of the elders of the church. We have 3 prayer meetings, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. Wednesdays is a teleconferencing meeting. If you have your bulletin, the numbers are there. The dial-in is at 7 o'clock. There's also a prayer meeting on a Wednesday. On a Friday, we have a face-to-face prayer meeting in the back room in there at 7 o'clock also. It's a good time to connect with the Lord and to intercede for our brothers and sisters who are here with us and from far away. And there's also a special prayer meeting every Saturday, a teleconferencing prayer meeting with Sister Patricia for the nation of Israel. How good is that? We pray for the nation of Israel. We are one with them. We are in solidarity. We are one big family. Amen. So any inquiries you may have, any questions you may have, is anything, please do contact Sister Patricia. And special announcement also for next week. What is next week? Well, I think the mothers remember that. How about the fathers? Do you remember? It's Mother's Day. Okay. Thank you very much. That's a good awakening for us. Mother's Day. So we'll be celebrating that. So on the 12th, is it on the 12th? Yeah, on the 12th, Mayona Park. And the address is there. Please, those who are intending to join, well, you want to join, right? The address is here, and please contact Pastor Yvonne for more details. Okay. So family is very important. Bring the whole family, and we stick together as a family, and more so as a family of God. Amen. There's more in the bulletin, so grab your copy. We want to listen to the word of God, to the messenger God sent to us. So, Pastor Tyrone, please come with us, join us this morning. And also a special thing, we will have our tithes and offerings. Just make sure that there are 2 offerings today, one for tithes and offerings and the other one for a love gift to Pastor Tyrone, who continually serves the Lord in a very passionate way. So take note of those things. So after the sermon message, after Pastor Tyrone has delivered the message, I will collect a love offering for Pastor Tyrone. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. Good to be with you. Pastor Denny said, please be there. So I'm here. I'm glad to be with you. Let me share a few stories with you. How many of you like to have a story? Jesus was a great storyteller. You know, Jesus was the greatest in history. You know why? Because it is his story. It is not about us. It is about Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. A couple together with their mother-in-law traveled in the land of Israel. And the mother-in-law passed away. I think maybe you have heard the story. And the undertaker said, we can do this for just $500 if you're doing it in Israel. But if you're shipping the corpse, you have to pay $10,000. And the man thought for a while. And he said, I'll take the second option. I want to ship her back to her home country. So the undertaker said, why are you doing it? You can do it just for below $500. And you know what the son-in-law said? You know, I don't want to bury her here because I have heard of a story of people rising from the dead. And so I don't want to bury her here. I want to bury her there. Well, the land of Israel is the land of the resurrection. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. You know, the land of Israel for 2,000 years were no land. It was no man's land. It was just desert. It was not producing. But when the people of the land came back, it began to flourish. Hallelujah. And if you look at nations that are turning their back to Israel, those nations are going from bad to worse. But those who have made peace with Israel are prospering. And I want you to know one country. Let me tell you one country that is prospering today that has made peace with Israel is India. India is prospering because they have not turned their back on Israel. Every nation that turned their back on Israel is just going down and down. They're not going up. And so, as churches, when we look to Israel and we blessed, because see, Jesus wept over Jerusalem. We should be able to weep with Jesus for Jerusalem. Jesus forgave the Jewish people for the wrongs they did. How many of you know that? Jesus forgave them. And we need to forgive them for what they did to Yeshua HaMashiach by nailing him to the cross. Yes, he forgave them. What did he say on the cross? Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they're doing. We should be thankful for what they did, because the whole world receives salvation because of Yeshua dying on the cross. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Another story. Before I go into my message, there was a boy in school that never studied. He was very bad in maths. And his teacher did everything possible. Everything possible to encourage him to study math. But the child would not study math. He disliked it. And so they called the parents for a parent-teacher meeting and told the parents, this child, John, is not studying and not interested in math at all. We do not know what to do with him. And the parents tried to coach him up and say, son, you got to do it. You got to do it. There's no option. He came to class. He was a total failure in math. One day, the teacher decided, I am going to take him to the chapel. I'm going to take him to the chapel. So she took John, little John, by the hand and took him into the chapel and said, John, you stay here and I'll come in half an hour to pick you up. I'll come in half an hour to pick you up. And in half an hour, when the teacher came back, picked him up, He became so good in maths. And the teacher asked him, how did this transformation take place? You know what he said? It will shock you. He said, I saw a man hanging on a plus sign. And I thought that's going to happen to me too if I don't study maths. That's why I began to put my heart and soul into maths. So friends, can we give Jesus a clap offering? He saw Jesus hanging on the cross on a plus sign. When you follow Jesus, you will have a plus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I have more stories to tell you, but I'll tell them as I go along. Amen? Stories are good. Jesus, that's why coming to church is a good thing. You see that plus sign there? Jesus came to add to your life, not to take away from you. Jesus came to give life. And this life is only found in Yeshua, Jesus Christ himself. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now in John chapter 6, this is not my message. There's no Bible study, by the way. I'm going to do a little bit of that as well. After the service, there's no Bible study, so we can spend a little more time. I don't know how. They did not tell me when I should stop. You know, Sri Lanka is below India. And Indian preachers are normally long. I've had them in my church. They have a lot to give and they are long. But Sri Lanka is below India. And I think I'm a little bit better than some of the Indian preachers. So I'll try to cut short. But I want to give you all that I can in this jar, in this clay, jar of clay. There is so much of wealth that God, the Holy Spirit, has put inside that I want to give you. But I have to be led by the Holy Spirit to know what I should give you this morning. So pray for me. Okay? I need prayer. In John chapter 6, in 5. Let's go there. John chapter 5. I want to give you a little bit of food for thought this morning before I get into my message. Real message. Thank you, Jesus. In John chapter 5, if you have your Bibles, and verse 39, I think I need a new pair of glasses. 39, Jesus said, you study the scriptures diligently because you think that in them you have eternal life. These are the very scriptures that testify about me, yet you refuse to come to me to have life. Isn't that an amazing thing? The Jews studied the word of God. What was the word of God that they studied? I want you to know they studied the word of God. What did they study? What did they study as the word of God? They studied the Torah. How many of you know Torah? So this is Torah. Jesus said, you are studying the scriptures diligently because you believe in them you have life. But those are the very scriptures that testify about me, and you still refuse to come to me to have that life. That's where the Jews failed. Because God never wanted to give us a religion. He wanted to give us a relationship. Hallelujah. He did not want to give us a religion. He wanted to give us a relationship. He was Abraham's friend. He said, I cannot hide anything from Abraham because he's going to be a great nation. Say hallelujah. So let me explain Torah to you. Torah is made with the Hebrew letters Tav, Vav, Resh, and He. Tav, Vav, Resh, and He. And do you know, like when we was in kinder, we used to study A for apple. We don't have them. We have to buy them in Sri Lanka. You have them here. So in the same way, the Jews had symbols for each letter in the Jewish alphabet. How many of you want to know the Jewish alphabet from your Bible? If you go to Psalm 119, you would find the Jewish alphabet there. And you can start studying it. So, now let me show to all of you Torah. Tau means cross. Tau means cross. And Vav means nail. Vav means nail. And Resh means person. And He is a window that reveals. So let me go from the way we read English. Revealing the person nailed to the... That's what Torah is about. Say hallelujah. Revealing the person nailed to the cross. When Jesus said, you study the scriptures diligently because you believe in them you have life. These are the very scriptures that testify about me. Yet you refuse to come to me to have that life. So if you have Jesus, you have eternal life. You have abundant life. You have full life. Say hallelujah. So I'm going to leave this. I'm going to pass it to you, and so that you can have a closer look. You know, magnify. Magnify. And if you want to take a picture of with your phone, you can take it. Because see, how did they miss it? How did they miss Jesus? Yeshua. They were studying. If you go to Israel, I've been there, you'll find the Orthodox Jews, they're reading a little book even while they walk on the streets. They're studying the Torah. Yet they missed the person whom Torah is revealing. Say hallelujah. We have found him. Say amen. We who are not a people are now God's people, the Bible says. Isn't that wonderful? Praise the Lord. Brother, I give it to you to pass it on. So that everyone, if you want to take a photo shot, you're welcome to do that. I give you permission. Praise the Lord. Now let me tell you another story. Okay. How many of you know God's name is Yahweh? Yahweh. In other words, the sound of way, way. Way. We all came here through some way. But he is the way. Okay, Yahweh. This is how Yahweh is spelled in Hebrew. Yod-heh-vav-heh. Can you see it? Yod-heh-vav-heh. Now, what are the symbols? What are the letters? Yod is hand. See, Yod is hand. You see the hand? That's what, like A for apple, B for bat, you play cricket, you have a bat. We love, Sri Lankans love to play Australia. And when we beat them, we are the most exciting people on earth because Australia is the best. And when you beat the best, you become the best. Praise God. So you'd hey. This is hey. This is revealing. I showed you on that other brochure that I sent or leaflet that I sent you. Hey is a window. What do you do? What do you get from a window? Why do you have a window? To have light. Is only light? You want to see what's happening outside. Amen? So not only are you getting light, but you can see what's going on the outside. So, then we have Vav. We told you Vav is a nail. Vav is a sign of a nail. And He is back again revealing. So, when you think of Yahweh, what is that name revealing? What is the revelation behind Yahweh? You know what the revelation is? Hand revealing. Nail revealing. Amen? So let me go from English, the English language. We go from left to right. The Jews go from right to left. So let's go. Revealing the nail, revealing the hand. What Who has the nail in the hand? Jesus. Yahweh is revealing. Yeshua nailed. Nailed to the cross, nailed the hand. Okay, final one before I go to my message. Giving you a little bit of information. How many of you know that when God provided rain for Israel, how many of you know there was a drought during the time of Elijah? There was a drought for 3 years and 3.5 years. There was a drought and there was no rain. But at one particular time, God said to Elijah, there's going to be rain. And Elijah could hear showers of blessings coming. Even though God told him that there's going to be rain, he believed that he should pray. Just because God gives you a word doesn't mean to say that that word is automatically going to come to pass. You can only see that come to pass by praying, by calling, by asking God to do that which he has said. Because unless you ask, you will not receive. Because there are principles in the kingdom of God. Just like there are laws in Australia, there are laws in the kingdom. Ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will open. So if you don't practice these principles, you will not get, oh, God said it's going to happen and nothing seemed to be happening. Well, for it to happen, you got to pray. Everything is wrought by prayer. Paul says, by prayer and petition, let your request be known unto God. And then the peace which passes all human understanding shall flood your hearts and mind in Christ Jesus. Some of you have peaces, not peace. You can only have peace through Yeshua. Now let's see. Did you know that when Elijah went to pray and he put his head beneath his knees and fell on the ground, he sent his servant, go and see. See, this is watch and pray. This is watch and pray. Some people watch and pray. Watch and pray. Some of you may be watching your watch. What time is Pastor Tyrone going to finish? Well, I'll finish when the Holy Spirit is finished with me. Amen? So let me tell you, how many of you, amen, let's give the Holy Spirit a round of applause. Yes, Holy Spirit, thank you for being with us this morning. Now, he went 6 times and nothing happened. Some of you are going so many times and nothing seemed to be happening. Never give up. Never give up. One day, Prime Minister Winston Churchill was invited for a graduation program. He had to give the main speech that evening. And suddenly his car broke down. And he delayed. By the time he got it fixed and he arrived at the graduation ceremony, he was late. And the organizers came to Sir Winston Churchill and told him, sir, you got only 5 minutes. He had 25 minutes, but his delay cost him. He says, 5 minutes is too much. And he came up to the podium and he told those graduates this. What did he say? Never give up. He paused for a while and again he said, never, never give up. And he paused for a little more and he said, never, 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 ever give up. And he received the greatest round of applause he had ever. And that was his speech. That's all he said. We as believers, we should never, never, ever give up. We should press in because God wants to do it. He's looking at our faith. And so Elijah sent the man the seventh time. And when he sent him the seventh time, what did the man see? What did he see? He saw a cloud of the size of a man's hand. Yeshua is a hand. And someone wrote a song and said, put your hand in the hand of the man who stills the waters. Hallelujah. His name is Yeshua. This is how Yeshua is spelled. Yod. You know Yod. Shin. Vav. And Ayin. That's how Yeshua is spelled. And that's the hand. That's the hand. Without his hand, nothing happens. Hallelujah. And before long, the whole skies were filled with clouds. And that's the day Elijah ran faster than the chariot. When the Holy Spirit is on you, you can run faster than a chariot. Hallelujah. Because you have the hand. Hallelujah. Amen. The hand. He touched me. How does he touch us? With the hand. Okay. You can take a photo of that as well. I won't charge you anything. You can take a photo of that as well. Amen. Hallelujah. Why I'm bringing this is because we serve a Jewish Jesus. We take communion of his body and blood. Did you know that you are a Jew too? Because the main olive branch was broken so that the wild olive branch would be grafted in. So if the roots are Jewish, we are Jewish too. If the bark is Jewish and the branches are Jewish, you and I are enjoying everything that God promised to Abraham. Hallelujah. We are Abraham's seed through Jesus Christ. And you need to know that you are a peculiar people. When you read the book of Esther, one of the accusations that Haman brought against the Jewish people to King Xerxes is they are a different, peculiar people. They don't mix with others. What does the Bible say? Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. This is the greatest battleground. How many of you know where the greatest treasures are lying today? That's right. At the cemetery. The greatest treasures that could make people rich are all down there. So use what you got for Yeshua's purposes and for his glory. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now this morning I'm going to speak about a Jewish boy. But he's not Jesus. He's not Jesus. See, many people say, you know, different things about the Jews, but I love them because God loves them. Whatever God loves, I love. And so, I just want you to know that Peter, James, and John, all are Jews. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Daniel, they were Jews. And Matthew, John, they were Jews. And so we have a Jewish Jesus and a whole bunch of Jews that got saved because of Jesus' prayer on the cross. He said, Father, forgive them. And that prayer was answered. You know, Stephen prayed a prayer. Do not lay this charge on this man. Who was the man? Paul was the man. He was called Shaul. In Hebrew, he's called Shaul. And Saul became Paul, and he was an amazing man when he expounded the scriptures. He, being a Jew, you know, sometimes when you learn of a Jew, it's amazing. They have so much of depth in what they're saying. And I want to draw your attention to what this man, Paul, said in Colossians chapter 2. And from this, I'll go to my message. And this is all sidelined the things that I'm giving you. Wealth, treasure. If you have Jesus, you have everything. If you don't have Jesus, you may have everything, but you have nothing. In Jesus, you have everything. Look at what Paul says in Colossians chapter 2. I want you to know how hard I am contending for you and for those at Laodicea. And for all who have not met me personally. My goal is that they may be encouraged in heart and united in love, so that they may have the full riches of complete understanding, in order that they may know the mystery of God, namely Christ. The mystery and the history is Christ. Amen. Paul is saying, if you know him, you got it all right. Then he goes on to say, in whom, can you read with me? In whom, can you say that? In whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. All the treasures of wisdom and knowledge is abiding in one person. And that person is Yeshua. That's why you need him. That's why I need him. I need thee. The hymn writer said, I need thee. Oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to thee. I need thee. Oh, I need thee. Without you, I'll be drifting. I'll be drifting. So thank God that Paul recognized. He studied under Gamaliel, a great Jewish teacher. He was from the tribe of Benjamin. He was circumcised on the eighth day. Do you know why they circumcised on the eighth day? Because it's only on the eighth day that the blood begins to clot. If you circumcise on the seventh day, he will bleed to death. See how marvelous our God is. All the knowledge is in Christ. If you have Christ, you are going to be a wise person. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so, coming to my message, Daniel chapter 6. How do you get to know this amazing person? In the Old Testament, the new is concealed. Everybody say that. In the old. Everybody say it. In the old, the new is concealed. In the new, the old is revealed. In the new, the old is revealed. Say amen. Hallelujah. When did Jesus die according to the scriptures? Before the foundations of the world was laid, he died. Because to God, he doesn't have a 24-hour realm. He's out of time. He's always on time. He's always able. And so, because he's outside of time, because he's unlimited, because he's omnipotent, omnipresence, he is able to see what you and I don't see. He says in Jeremiah, I know the plans I have for you. Okay, how do I know about those plans? By praying, by seeking God. He's able to give you revelation where it's going to just open the doors of your life to go walk through. Hallelujah. I'm excited. I'm excited. I have 5 points to share with you. And then I'll close. Let's see whether we could go quickly. Daniel chapter 6. Daniel chapter 6. Let me read to you. Hallelujah. I'm glad you have your Bibles. Remember, we must be people of the book. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, now all of us go on GPS. And sometimes people tell me GPS takes you the longer route. But in the good old days, I know you had a big fat book that you kept in your cars that you had to quickly roll the pages and see how to get to where you should get. Now many have given up the book. Friends, I want you to come back to the Bible. Hallelujah. Come back to the Bible. Start reading the hardcover. And let your eyes, you know, when you read the Bible from pages, it is more healthier than reading the Bible through your different electronic items that you're having. Because your eyes get tired when you look at that blue light. But when you read from the scriptures, like from the pages, your eyes do not get tired as what you do through your phones and through your iPads and other devices. Let me read to you. It pleased Darius to appoint 120 satraps to rule throughout the kingdom with three administrators over them. One of them was Daniel. The satraps were made accountable to them so that the king might not suffer loss. Now Daniel so distinguished himself among the administrators and the satraps by his exceptional qualities that the king planned to set him over the whole kingdom. Say hallelujah. What do you know about Daniel? What did he do? He was a man who prayed. How did he pray? He opened his windows towards Jerusalem and he prayed in that direction. Whenever you face Jerusalem, you are going to prosper. I'm telling you, some of you were here on that Friday that I was speaking about Ruth, and when Elimelech, Naomi, and Kilion and Mahalon, they decided because of a bad situation in Israel, they went to Moab country. What were they doing? They were turning their backs on Jerusalem. They were from Bethlehem. Beth stands for house. Lechem stands for bread. But there was no bread in the house. So they turned their backs and they started walking towards Moab country because there was plenty in that country. And what happened to Naomi, Elimelech, Mahalon and Kilion? What happened to them? Elimelech died and Naomi became a widow. Mahalon died. And Kilion died, and Orpah and Ruth became widows as well. The mother, Naomi, decided, I'm going back to my people. I'm going back to Bethlehem. Hallelujah. I'm going to Bethany. I'm going home. And when they came home, there was hope. In the hopelessness that they were, when they came to Israel, when they came to Jerusalem, when they came to Bethlehem, they found their hopelessness, hopefulness. Amen. They found grace. They were disgraced when they left and they were living in that country. They were in shame. They were disgraced. When Naomi came and they all of Bethlehem was stirred up when Naomi came. Say hallelujah. When you come back, there's a stirring taking place. Hallelujah. There was stirring taking place. And so they said, Naomi has come. And Naomi said, don't call me Naomi. Call me Mara, for I went full and I'm coming in disgrace. But I want you to know, His grace can cover your disgrace. His grace can cover any man's disgrace if they come to Jesus. If you're in Christ, you're covered. Say covered. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm covered. So Daniel was a man of excellence. Say hallelujah. What made him an excellent man? What made him an honest man? What made him such a great man that the king wanted to appoint him above them all? He was a man of... What did he do most? He prayed to the God of Israel. And so my first point, a righteous person is a good testimony. A righteous person. And if you're a righteous person, one of the things you must do, even if you don't do any other thing, you must do, you must read your Bible and pray every day. How many of you know that that's the... We tell the children, read your Bible and pray every day. But we adults don't read our Bibles. We are only lecturing them. You know, whenever a cricketer who's a great cricketer stop performing well and not scoring those runs, you know what they do to that cricketer? They take him aside and takes him back to basics. Can we say back to basics? Back to basics. So he has to block the ball, not hit the ball. If you know to block the ball, the time will come, your patience will give you the opportunity to hit that ball out of the ground. Amen? So when we fail, when Christians fail, we need to take a good check on us and go back to basics. Read your Bible and pray every day if you want to grow, if you want to prosper. So Daniel, a righteous person, is a good testimony as a man of prayer. That's my first point. The king was acknowledging, this is the man I'm going to appoint over all the affairs of Babylon. Number two, a righteous person will face opposition. A righteous person will face opposition. If you live for Jesus, you will face opposition. You know, I hear certain preachers say, come to Jesus and all your problems will be solved. But the other side of the coin is, come to Jesus and all your problems will begin. Because when I came to Jesus and I started living for Him, things began to go the wrong way. My mother wanted me out of the house. He has found another religion. I didn't find another religion. I found the same Jesus. Amen. I found Him as not a religion. I found Him in relationship. My life changed. So Daniel was an amazing man. He was a Jew. Amen. He was a lover of Yahweh, and he publicly opened his windows and prayed to God, asking. He would have probably read Psalm and said, I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So he was boldly, even though a Jew in Babylon, he was boldly praying to Yahweh, and he received strength to be a righteous person. You need strength to be a righteous person in today's context. Look at what's happening all around you. It's very difficult to live holy. It takes guts, it takes courage. You need the boldness that comes from above. So Daniel received that. Number two is, you find opposition. If you're going to live for Jesus, you find opposition.
But live anyway. Live for him anyway, no matter what. They all began to connive with one another to try and put Daniel in trouble. Some of you may be having that kind of situation in your job, at your job, or at your workplace, or somewhere, wherever you are. There's opposition, not because you're not performing, because they're jealous of you. That you have found favor. Say hallelujah. When you pray, you find favor. So opposition, let's see 4 and 5. At this, the administrators and the satraps tried to find ground for charges against Daniel in his conduct of government affairs. But they were unable to do so. They could find no corruption in him because he was trustworthy and neither corruption nor negligent. Say hallelujah. You can read up to verse 9. Let me read. So these administrators and satraps went as a group to the king and said, May King Darius live forever. The royal administrators, prefects, satraps, advisors, and governors have all agreed that the king should issue an edict and enforce the decree that anyone who prays to any god or human being during the next 30 days, except to you, your majesty, shall be thrown into the lion's den. Now your majesty issue the decree and put it in writing so that it cannot be altered in accordance with the law of the Medes and Persians, which cannot be repealed. So King Darius put the decree in writing. People want to stop us praying. The devil, you know what devil means in, or Satan means in Hebrew? Satan. In our Sinhala Bible, Satan is called Satan. You know, the Sinhala language is more close to Hebrew than the English language. See, if you go and read the Sinhalese Bible, for Paul, it says Shaul. For David, it says David. Actually, David's name is David. For Isaac, it says Isaac. Isaac is the real Hebrew name. Amen. So some of you Sinhalese here, we are a little bit closer to Hebrew. And did you know that the Sinhalese language is like the Hebrew language? Because in the English language, you can say love. I love my wife. I love my dog. I love my house. I love my car. It's all love. But in Sinhala and in Hebrew, there are several words that could be used to specifically say what kind of love. And one of the loves that we have in the Bible that Jesus showed is agape. That's, of course, in Greek, agape, agape love. So, they wanted to put you in trouble. So, they'll find the most important thing. Prayer is connection. You can have the best equipment, but if you're not connected, you can't use. You can have the best phone. If your internet is not connected, you're useless. As a Christian, if you're not connected to Yahweh, Yeshua, through prayer, you are useless. And Satan knows that. And he wants to stop you doing one thing. He stop you praying. Don't give up. What did number 3? A righteous person is a bold person on his convictions. A righteous person is a bold person because he lives by convictions. Amen? See, when there is conviction, there is conversion. They were convicted and struck to the heart, the book of Acts says. And they said, what must we do to be saved? Friends, conviction leads to conversion. Many are praying the sinner's prayer. Oh, Lord Jesus, I give you my heart, Lord Jesus. If they are not convicted of sin, righteousness, and the judgment to come, they won't have a proper conversion. Friends, this beautiful morning, when you are a righteous person, you have a holy boldness. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, we had an amazing pastor called Pastor Colton Vikramaratne in Sri Lanka. He's an amazing man. He used to minister to pastors. And one day I remember him saying, even dead fish can swim downstream, but you need a live one to swim upstream. Amen. Friends, the tides are against you. But if you are alive in Christ, you can swim against it. Say hallelujah. I can do all things, Paul said, through Christ who strengtheneth me. Hallelujah. In my own self, I can do nothing. But Christ in me, I can do. Did you know something? That when God wanted to create the fish, he spoke to the sea. When he wanted to create all the herbs and the trees, he spoke to the earth. But did you know when he wanted to make man, he spoke to himself and said, let us make man in our image and in our likeness. Say hallelujah. He spoke to himself. That's why we are the crown of the creation. That's why the devil is after you, because you bear the image of the living God. Holy boldness. Let me read to you. What did Daniel do when he heard the news? Verse 10 to 16. Now when Daniel learned that the decree had been published, he went home to his upstairs room where the windows opened towards Jerusalem. Jerusalem. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. Yes. I need it. Thank you. See, she had wisdom. She knew I was choking because I'm shouting. Amazing that when he heard, I was going to tell you a story. You and I are the amazing creation of God. I don't know why the devil is not after the dogs. But the devil is after us. They are not after the leopards. They are not after the elephants. They are not after the lions. They are not even after the lambs and the sheep. They are after us. Because we are the glory bearers. Hallelujah. We are the ones who are bringing the glory. We are the ones who are glorified. Did you know that? Oh, don't take the glory. No, I didn't take the glory. He gave me glory. How can I give glory if I don't have glory? By the way, it's not a name of a person. In Romans chapter 8, in the last few verses, you go home and read it, you'd find those whom he sanctified, he glorified. And so we are glorified and we have glory. And what do with the glory? We don't glory in the glory. We give the glory. Hallelujah. We give the glory. How can you give if you don't have? God has given you glory. So what did he do? He went and opened his windows. He had a holy boldness. He was fearless because he knows my Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. Hallelujah. My Redeemer lives. Hallelujah. He knew that. He went home like nothing had happened. Would you do that? If the government had issued a decree, I think we need the grace of God and the Holy Spirit's boldness. When Peter was cautioned and said, you cannot preach in this name. He said, whether it be right or wrong, we cannot but speak in the name of Jesus. You know, when the Sanhedrin and all the religious leaders, the Pharisees and the, you see, Sadducees, they were sad because they didn't believe in angels. They didn't believe in the resurrection. They didn't believe in afterlife. So they are Sadducees. I would say they have been given the right name, right? See, nature gives people right names. So they said, we cannot but stop speaking in this name, Jesus. And when the Sanhedrin saw, they took note that these fisher folk had been to school with Jesus. They was in the Jesus Mobile Bible School. Wherever Jesus went, they went. And they were learning. You don't have to be in a classroom to learn. You can learn while you're walking. You can learn while you're moving. Hallelujah. And so, they took note that they had been with, not with religion, that being with Jesus. The holy boldness comes when you're with Jesus. You know, can I tell a story? There's a gentleman in our church called Uncle Lionel. Because he's a little bit older, we call him Uncle. Sometimes Australians can be offended when you call them Uncle. Some people, children call me Uncle. I said, am I so... my countenance has changed. And so they call me Uncle. And I cannot help it. I have grown. My hair betrays me. And so Uncle Lionel would come every Friday and ask me to pray for him. This went on for 6 months. 6 months. I know at the end of the prayer meeting, Uncle Lionel will be there. What is his problem? His problem, he has a pain on his tongue. A terrible pain. And it has gone for 6 months. I'm anointing him with oil. I'm praying, laying my hands. I gave him a prayer handkerchief. Nothing seemed to be working. Now I know Uncle Lionel is going to come today after the Friday prayer meeting is over. It's a fasting and prayer. So Uncle Lionel came. I was desperate. I was desperate. So I said, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. Either something is wrong with him or something is wrong with me. Nothing is wrong with you. Amen. I know nothing is wrong with God. Something is wrong. Lord, tell me. Is there anything that he got to do? Or is there anything that I got to do? I will do it. Now this is scary. Sometimes you have to have a holy boldness to do God's work. You know, if you hear his voice today, do not harden your heart. So I heard that inner voice saying, take some of your saliva and apply it on his tongue. I said, oh God, I can't do that. This man will see it. And then the inner voice said, ask him to close his eyes. I said, Brother Lana, close your eyes. Put your tongue out. And I quickly took and I placed my hand and I prayed. And on Sunday, he was coming smiling. Pastor, I am healed. I am healed. I am healed. The pain has gone. The pain has gone. Jesus has healed me. You got to have a holy boldness, friends, to do the work of God. And he was healed. And since that day, he has never come up to me and asked me to pray for his tongue. Can we give the Lord a clap offering? Hallelujah. A holy boldness. Daniel had a holy boldness. And he opened his windows and prayed. If I was Daniel, I would have closed the windows and prayed. But when you have that holy boldness, you are fearless. You are ruthless. I was speaking on Ruth. And one gentleman came after the service and says, he said, Pastor, I need prayer. I said, what is it, brother? My wife is ruthless. Actually, his wife's name was Ruth. And he came up to me and said, my wife is ruthless, Pastor. Please. He was actually joking. Friends, I want you to know, you have a holy boldness. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you shall receive dunamis, power, boldness. Fourth point. A righteous person is never abandoned by God. A righteous person is never abandoned by God. David said, if I take the wings of the morning and go to the utmost parts of the earth, or utmost parts of the sea, thou art there. If I dig deep and make my bed in hell, thou art there. This knowledge is too wonderful. He can go wherever he wants to go. He never abandons you. What did Jesus say? Lo, I am with you even unto the end of the ages. End. I can guarantee you, mama, dada will leave you. Husband, wife will leave you. But Jesus will never leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Friends, I just want you to know, God did not abandon Daniel. The scriptures for that is 17 to 24. Let me read it quickly. A stone was brought and placed over the mouth of the den. He was thrown into the den. That's the penalty. If I make my bed in hell, lions' dens can be hell. And so he was thrown into the den, and a large stone was placed over the mouth of the den. And the king sealed it with his own signet ring and with the rings of his nobles. So Daniel's situation might not be changed. So that Daniel's situation might not be changed. Then the king returned to his palace and spent the night without eating and without any entertainment being brought to him. And he could not sleep. Say hallelujah. When you pray, you go to the book of Esther, the king could not sleep. When they had fasted and prayed, I tell you can keep kings awake. Say hallelujah. Prayer can keep kings awake. They don't have entertainment. When you're suffering, they're suffering. Because they know you're a righteous person. This is unfair. If you're treated unfair, wait on God. Your day is coming. Hallelujah. The books are going to be open. And so, the king could not sleep that night. He did not eat that night. He was fasting. Verse 19. At the first light of dawn, the king got up and hurried to the lion's den. When he came near the den, he called to Daniel. He called to Daniel in an anguished voice. Daniel! I like when the Bible shouts, I like to shout. You know, when Jesus came to Lazarus' tomb, he said, Lazarus? No. I shout where the Bible shouts. Amen. He said, Daniel. I've almost said Lazarus. Daniel, Daniel, poor Dan. Daniel is flying tonight on a plane. Have you heard that song? It's a sad song. Daniel, 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 are you alive? Are you alive? Well, dead people don't talk. Amen? Dead people don't talk. Dead people don't talk. Daniel, servant of the living God. Hallelujah. What God? Servant of the... Our God is a living God. He died. He's raised. He's risen. Servant of the living God. Has your God, whom you serve continually. When is he serving? What does Paul say? Pray without ceasing. This is the will of God. Daniel, the God whom you are serving continually, being able to rescue you from the lions, a voice from inside came out. Say hallelujah. Daniel answered, may the king live forever. My God sent his angel, and he shut the mouths of the lions. They have not hurt me because I was found innocent in his sight. Nor have I ever done any wrong before you, your majesty. Say hallelujah. He was not done anything wrong. When you're a praying person, you can avoid a lot of wrong. See, when you're prayerless, you're careless. When you're prayerful, you're powerful. Say amen. Prayerless, careless. You go and knock that car in front. But when you're prayerful, you're powerful. You're powerful to hit that brake on time. And then you realize God is with us. Emmanuel. Emmanuel. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Number five, a righteous person makes a difference for the Lord. Abraham said to God, if there are 50 righteous men, will you destroy? You know, this nation can be protected because of your righteousness. Because you are living for him. You are committed by him. You are totally committed. Friends, a righteous man, a righteous woman makes a difference for the Lord. 25 to 28, and we can close. I'll give you a few scriptures. If you can read 25 to 28, let me read to you. Then King Darius wrote to all the nations and peoples of every language in all the earth, may you prosper greatly. I issue a decree that in every part of my kingdom, people must fear and reverence the God of Daniel. For he is the living God. Say hallelujah. And he endures forever. Hesaha makarahati. His kingdom will not be destroyed. His dominion will never end. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus is the winner man. Jesus is the winner man. The winner man. The winner man. Jesus is the winner man. The winner man all the time. Come on, say, I am on the winning side. The winning side. The winning side. I am on the winning side. The winning side all the time. Amen. I'm on the winning side. Let me read on. He rescues, verse 27, he rescues and saves. Say hallelujah. What's the character of our God? He rescues and saves. No other God saves. Because there is no other. There is only one God and one mediator between God and man, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He rescues and saves. He performs signs and wonders in the heavens and on earth. He has rescued Daniel from the power of the lions. So Daniel prospered during the reign of Darius and the reign of Cyrus the Persian. Say Persian. Say Persian. Where is the trouble? From Persia. But God can bring a newness. Where Persia, God can bring a Darius or a Cyrus. Amen? Because what was will be, Solomon says. And what is will continue to be. So even though there is opposition in the world, God can bring favor. Like for Daniel, he can change things overnight. Say amen. Hallelujah. He does signs in the heavens. For he is truly God. This is our God. This is our God. Hallelujah. I'll give you a few more scriptures and then you can go home and read. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The scriptures are Psalms 37 verse 2, 12 and 13. The wicked plot against the righteous and gnash their teeth at him. But the Lord laughs at the wicked, for he sees that his day is coming. Amen. Psalm 37 verse 12 and 13. Psalm 37 verse 32 and 33. The wicked watches for the righteous and seeks to put him to death. The Lord will not abandon him. Say hallelujah. Go home and read those scriptures. And encourage yourself. You may be going through turmoil. You may be going through trouble. Don't give up. For you're going to get a trophy. You're going to get a trophy if you're in trouble. Hallelujah. Friends, this is exactly what God wants to do for you and me. But we got to do one thing. The Bible says, seek him while he may be found. Call on him while he is near. Bartimaeus did that. He shouted. Amen. Don't wait till the presence of God has gone to call. Call on him now. Hallelujah. Shall we stand in closing? Friends, I want to challenge you. I'm no big man. I'm a crackpot. And out of this crackpot, the light shines. I'm a bruised reed. I'm a broken person. But I have gone to Jesus in prayer. I've gone to Jesus in prayer. And prayer has worked. Prayer has worked. And prayer will work. Hallelujah. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven, forgive their sins and heal their land. Pray for Israel that their blindness will be taken away and they'll see Yeshua as the hand that provides for them. Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you for this beautiful morning. I can sense your anointing and presence in this place. Lord, I pray that each of these, your children, will take the word and work, put the word to work in their lives. They will get down and pray. They will open their windows and pray, looking. Lord Jesus, we don't need to look to Jerusalem anymore. But Lord, we do know we can look above. We can look to Jesus. We can look to Jesus and we can call upon him in the day of trouble. And he will deliver. For he's a deliverer. He's a rescuer. Bless this church, Lord. One thing I know, and this may be a prophetic word, what the enemy meant for evil, God can turn it for the good and for the saving of many lives. God bless you.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son.